Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to another special episode of One Bite with Mr. Lib. We are here in the Liberatory Kitchen.
I've got my pizzeria shirt on.
And where's today's special guest? Also, I feel like I'm missing something. I'm missing something with today's episode. That's better. I am here with our special guest today, my baby girl, Phoebe. Okay? And we have a very special review today. My wife, Taylor, my incredible wife, Taylor, has been begging for weeks to be on One Bite. She is quite the cook, okay? And today she has some of her famous flatbread pizza. Okay, we have some of the scenery here as well, some of the marinara that she used. Okay, so we have a very tough evaluation. It's going to be extremely hard for Mr. Lib to be objective here. Okay, so everyone knows the rules, Phoebe. 1 through 10, as you see, she's super excited about evaluating her mother's pizza. So let's check it out, Phoebe. Let's see what we've got. Let's first check out the flop. Yeah, sniff it. Decent flop from Mrs. Lib. Okay, how does the cheese look? Not greasy, definitely not greasy. Very nice job done by the wifey. Okay, everyone knows the rule, one bite. Good undercarriage, not too soft, definitely not burnt. The crust is good, the sauce, solid.
What do we think, Phoebe? What do you think?
Yeah. Let's give it one more bite. Okay, like I said last week, flatbread's usually not my favorite pizza. I'm trying to think what I gave Panera last week. I gave Panera a 6.9. This is definitely much better than Panera. I'm gonna give Mrs. Lip's homemade pizza a solid. Homemade flatbread pizza, solid 8.7.
Cause all of me loves all.
8.7 for Mrs. Lip's homemade flatbread pizza. All right, we are live from the Liberatory Kitchen. Again, this is Phoebe. This is the one and only Mr. Lip. And we'll see you next week for another episode of One Bite.
Bridgehampton School, Mr. Barker here, back for the day that needs no introduction, Friday. Mr. Lib is coming in with an epic one bite live from his house featuring the coolest pup other than Weather Bear, Phoebe. Man, I wish I had Weather Bear. I said, I wish I had Weather Bear. Why is this thing not working? Much better. Today is Friday, November 5th. It is an A day. Please stand for the pledge. That was Ariana Lucerna with our pledge today. Great job. Hey, let's check in with that weekend weather. Oh, hey, it's Yolanda Lazaro's cat Coco, and he's back for our weekend forecast. Coco's saying clear skies ahead, sunny in the 50s. So hey, here are announcements for the day. Second grade is bat to the bone. Get it? Their classroom mysteriously turned into a bat cave this week as they learned about bats and nocturnal animals. What an epic unit. I actually went into their classroom and got lost for 32 hours. It was scary. Bravo, second grade. In honor of bats, I am feeling a bat joke today. What did the bat say to her friend when she came back to school after her holiday? Welcome, bat. Anyway, go support the PTO with some brand new Bridgehampton gear. There is 1 week remaining until it disappears forever. And the Hampton Library has many weekly events this November. Next Tuesday at 3:30, you can make fairy garden terrariums to hang on your wall. Thank you, Ayana Eel, for this breaking news. And National Honor Society students, there is a meeting today at lunch with Miss Riley. And students, quarter one ends next Friday. Talk with your teachers about any assignments that you may need to make up. And the National Honor Society and Junior Honor Society are hosting a Thanksgiving food drive. You can donate non-perishable food items to help those in need this Thanksgiving. There is a donation box in the front lobby until November 19th. And lastly, we are continuing our 30 Days of Gratitude Challenge. If you'd like to follow along with our calendar, the link is in the description below. Today's challenge is to take a grateful meditation break, or this weekend, create a gratitude turkey craft, or take time for self-care to get some energy out and dance it out. I bet that Miss Ozu will definitely be following Saturday's challenge. Don't forget to subscribe to the morning announcement so that you can watch me tell cringy bat jokes sometimes. And hey, don't forget to change your clocks on Sunday. We are falling back an hour, 49 hours this weekend. This might be the best weekend of the year. All right, that's it for our announcements for the week. Sadly, the birthday streak is over, but we will announce our weekend birthdays on Monday. So from WBEE Virtual Radio, this is Mr. Barker signing off until Monday. Have an amazing weekend, Bridgehampton family. You deserve it.
Guys, always see the reference to learn on the same day.
So, are you a graduate and participate in something lovely when you leave for Champions?
Make sure washing hands is wet soap and put your mask on and please stay safe.
Good job.